Now that we can use search variations to retrieve additional search results, we'll want to make this process more efficient by utilizing multiprocessing. We'll start by importing two additional libraries, one to do the multiprocessing and the other to help us with some special iterator functions. Let's implement a super easy use case of multiprocessing. We'll define a new function, searchList, and we'll be able to pass in a list of search terms, notice the plural, not search term, and numResults. We'll instantiate the pool object in our code. I'm using the starMap function instead of map as I have multiple arguments. We'll use our function getResults and we'll zip together search terms and numResults. We use the repeat function on numResults so that it can match the variable length of search terms. Close and join help ensure proper cleanup of the multiprocessing. Then we can return the results. We're basically saying, hey, do this getResults function to each search variation we have in our list. And instead of running these processes one at a time from the top to bottom of our code, do them in tandem and return the results to us. If we go back into our search function, we can update the else statement. Rather than using a for loop to iterate over each search variation, we can use our search list function. And just to recap, functionally, this returns us the exact same information as previously, but the processing speed is much improved when utilizing multiprocessing. This will make a big difference for us when we want to start passing whole lists of search terms in the next video.